Could you start by telling us about the sale? Why now, and how much does it actually mean to either company?
So it's quite significant because historically, as you just mentioned, since 1974, Nestlé and L'Oréal had been linked together. They had this partnership because at the time, Liliane Bettencourt, the wealthy owner of L'Oréal, was attempting to fend off an attempt to nationalize L'Oréal. So that's why she was looking for a partner. She found this partner in Nestlé. So Nestlé actually remains significant shareholder even after selling this 8.9 billion euros stake, mm-hmm. because they will still have 20.1% of L'Oréal. They will keep two seats on the board. Now, the question is, as you mentioned, is whether this means the start of a total exit of L'Oréal. Yep. What will follow? What will Nestlé do with the proceeds of the sale? And this could also have an impact on Sanofi, because L'Oréal also owns 9% mm-hmm. of Sanofi, and L'Oréal executives, every time I was asking them about this stake, were saying this all depends what Nestlé does with their L'Oréal stake.
So, Caroline, how does this all fit into Nestlé's wider transformation plans?
So clearly, Mark Schneider, the CEO of Nestlé, has been attempting to focus on most profitable parts of the business, such as pet care, such as coffee. You know, they have Nespresso. They had also this partnership with Starbucks. So they started selling Nespresso capsules from Starbucks in supermarkets. And Mark Schneider really is trying to refocus the business. So we'll see what he does with the proceeds of this 8.9 billion euros. But a couple of months ago, when you had the latest update on Nestlé sales, they actually increased their forecast. They're betting on the best year for this year in a decade, with a 6.9% growth at Nestlé for this year, and L'Oréal as well. But this was also, of course, before we had the Omicron variant and possible impact on both Nestlé and L'Oréal.